In this way, in this video, we are going to see the continuation of the previous video, but the introduction to the Facebook behavior and process. So, what are the basic concepts in memory interface? The primary function is that microprocessor should be able to read from and write into a given register of a memory. So, how it identifies a particular register in a memory chip. So, to perform this, the microprocessor should be able to select the chip. Suppose some 5 memory chips are there, how it will select it? From which memory chip it has to read or write? So that is one. So selection of a particular chip and then identify the register. Okay. Within the chip, it has to identify a particular register. Then enable the appropriate buffer. Once it has selected, whether a reading buffer, that is output buffer, or the input buffer has to be enabled. That's what it has. So basically, 3 functions and memory interface has to be. First, it has to select the correct chip, then identify the respective register within that, then enable the appropriate buffer. This whether output buffer or the input buffer depending on the instruction given. So here before that, we will just see, already we have seen this timing diagram, but anyway, this is needed. This explanation is needed for further understanding this memory interface. Let's consider the instruction MVIA32S, that is move immediate into the accumulator the value 32. So once this instruction is executed, 32, the value 32 is moved to the accumulator. It will be returned in the accumulator. And it is a 2-byte instruction. So 2-byte instruction, it needs 2 machine cycles. The first machine cycle is to read the first opcode, and then the second machine cycle is needed for reading this data from the that is for executing this. Okay, so this opcode fetch, this is a two bytes. So 2 times the memory has to be read. That's one. So M1 is for the first opcode fetch. The second is for fetching this data. This is nothing but memory reading. This is also a memory reading only, but we call this as an opcode. And normally an opcode fetch needs 4 T cycles because here, let us consider this clock signal which is uniformly having a rising and lowering edge. So when it has a lowering and a rising edge, this is called 1T signal. So now we have this address bus and this is the data bus. Even if both are same, we show them separately. That is A15 and A02A. So this is lower order and this is higher order. And this is at the address latch enabled. So when this is high, it says that the data, whatever data placed is addressed. When it goes low, now it is ready for the data. And whatever is placed on the lower order will be considered as a, interpreted as a data now. Then IO slash UR, S1 is all the AD. When S1 is 1, S0 is 1, it is nothing but output fetch. These are all the status signals. Then IO slash UR, when it goes low, it indicates that it is a memory read. Whereas when it is high, it indicates that it is a reading from IO device, which is nothing but keyboard monitor. All those things are called as IO device. So when this signal itself indicates that IO must be high in order to read data from IO, read write from IO. And when M bar, it is here, low, it indicates when it goes low, it is reading from the memory. So that is thing, this same signal is used for multiple purpose. Okay, multiplex. It is multiplex. Then RT bar, the read signals. Since we are going to read it from the main memory, we now read signal will work out. So that is what given here. So when it is given as low, this bar is given, it is an active low. So when it goes low, it is reading from memory. That's one. Okay. Now, at T2, at T1, it will be stabilized, and then at T2 it goes low, indicating that now it is reading. Now after reading that, after it goes low, then RT bar also goes low, indicating that now it started reading. So when it reads this equivalent MVIA equivalent is CE output that is placed on the data bus, and it will be remaining there for 2 T cycles. Then it goes high, indicating reading is over. Now at T4, what happens? The instruction decoder decodes this instruction and finds that it is not a single byte, the insertion bleeding is not over yet. So it has to do another, it is a two-way insertion, so it has to initiate one more reading so that that data also is needed for complete interpretation. So now, again, I'm to next memory cycle starts, and the next, because this is placed in one memory called 2000, and this is placed in the next consecutive 2001. So that address is placed again on the address bus, both in a higher order, and then again here goes high, and then saying that this is successful. Again, after some time, it goes to TAP now, is ready to read the data. And RD bar is the, when it goes low, it allows, after it goes low, the RD bar also goes to indicating that now it is reading. Now the data 32, which is present in 2000, is placed on the data bus. Okay. Now at the T3, it will be interpreted and it will be understood by the microprocessor that the data will be moved from the data and it will be executed. So 8088 is 16-bit address of address bus. For the memory chip in previous slide, only 11 address lines are required. Here we have A0 to A50. But in this, if you see the previous one, we need only 11 address lines. Okay? We need only 11 address lines required to identify 2048. Therefore, A0 to A10 is connected to the memory chip. The remaining address line, it is from A11 to A15, is decoded to generate the chip select. Suppose there are more than one memory chip is there, from which chip it has to be read. So for that we use this A11. The selection of the chip is done by this. The two signals IO/MPAR and RD bar indicate the memory read operation. Memory places the data by the T2 of M2. Here this is. And while writing, write signal. So when it is reading from that, the same way, all these are same. The first memory cycle, memory cycle M1 is same. This is second memory cycle of any reading, any writing. So here again, on the T2 only, the data is from the data bus is placed on the MPU or from the microprocessor because it is a write signal. Write is to write into the memory of the memory. So from the microprocessor, the data comes and that will be placed on the T2 cycle of this M2. And then at that time, IO/MPAR goes low, indicating that it is a memory related operation. And then write, this also goes low, indicating now it can write. And together they generate MEMW bar.